A touch under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth.
Up front, it'll be Murray and Sabonis.
De'Aaron Fox is out there with Mitchell. And it's Herter in at the three. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. And blocked. That one goes careening off the glass. Pass to the dude.
All right, Richard, I was looking over your accomplishments, doing a little extra prep on you. An NBA title with the Cavs, a state title, and almost won it all in college at Arizona. Is that the one what-if in your career?
Oh, no. Thank you for bringing those up. But, yeah, I have tons of what-ifs. I have. I'd also like to talk about the two times I lost in the NBA Finals, going against Shaq and Kobe, then Tim Duncan, David Robinson, and Manu Ginobili. But the funny thing is, it's not like they didn't have Hall of Fame head coaches. It was only Phil Jackson and Greg Popovich. So, you know, I've run into a few buzzsaws in my day.
Pass to the dude. Murray against Mobley. Here's the dude. On the wing, Mitchell. No good with the triple. The Kings have gotten only 2 of 6 attempts to drop in the fourth. Garland against Mitchell. Sabonis with it. And give him another one. He's 6 of 8 and looking solid.
And it's clear that Sabonis has it going on right now. That defense is at his mercy.
Here's the dude. He's guarded by Barnes. Outside Garland. He takes it in. 6 to shoot. The 3 from Mitchell. Count that one. He's now 5 for 8.
It's just a sign of an elite scorer like Mitchell. When he receives the pass, he's looking to let it fly.
Sacramento has gone only 1 of 4 from the perimeter here in this fourth quarter. From deep, Mitchell. No good there. And it's Cleveland the other way. Here's the dude. Pass to Love. Here's the dude. On the wing, Mitchell. Here's the dude. He's guarded by Sabonis. Mobley with it. To the left side wing. Garland for 3. Knocks down the long J.
It's safe to say they have dominated this game. The game wasn't even as close as the score says in a great win for the Cavaliers.
And it was a big-time performance across the board. They looked like they were having fun out there, Grant.
Yeah, B.A., it was almost like watching a cat play with a mouse. I mean, they did pretty much anything they wanted to do out there today.
And with this one, they go double digits in the win column.
And they meet just twice, so taking the first meeting means a lot to this team.
And as it was happening, as it was building, you knew this was a monster game for the dude.
Okay, I'm going to explain what he did here. It's called playmaking. Being someone that seeks out their teammates, making the extra pass.
The dude gets the bucket.
This is what winning is all about. Playing your best when it matters most.
And let me tell you, as a team, you love to hit your stride right at the crucial moments. They put this game away in style.
Here's Herter. After the Cavs picked up a basket a moment ago. And there are the Kings with another bucket.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
He's just riding the wave of momentum right now, getting to his spots and keeping things simple on the offensive side.
Now here's Love. Here's the dude. Here's Garland. Sacramento grabs the miss. Now here's Mitchell. Out to the right wing. It's Barnes on the wing. And so it's the Cavaliers taking care of business in this one. This one wasn't even close. The hometown crowd was waiting for a miracle that never came.
Yeah, and this team was consistent throughout. They met every challenge, and they earned this dub.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Brian Anderson saying thank you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.
you think your college coach would be proud of the way you were dropping dimes all over the court tonight?
Yeah, coach sent me a text after the game. You know, he was really happy with our passing tonight. When we shared a ball like that, we're a tough team to beat.
Well, you know what they say, sharing is caring, and you in particular were throwing some pretty audacious passes. Where did that come from?
Yeah, we got a bunch of great athletes on this team. You know, guys who can go up, get the ball, even for a lob or whatever, whatever. Even if it's not a perfect pass, they're catching radiuses like Randy Moss out there. But it makes it a lot easier for me to, look good.
Well, you did look good tonight. Good game.
My niece loves Jake Duvall.
Oh, I'm hearing you're thinking about staying after all.
Yeah, things got a little emotional the other day, and this is where I want to be ultimately.
Great. Well, now all we gotta do is game plan.
Oh, wait. So, Mila and I, we discussed, and we think we wanna avoid the press in this. Just put my head down, focus, play the best basketball that I can play, because if Othello wants to trade me, he's gonna be the one that looks like a clown, not me.
Okay,
right, that's what I wanna do.
That is an option,
but play basketball.
I don't think it's our best one here, man.
All right, then, let me hear something.
Look, MP, you are a phenomenal player. I mean, you have unlimited potential, and I believe this, otherwise I wouldn't be here focusing all my energy on you like this. But right now you've already got an uphill battle with the fans. And as it stands, if Othello leaks a trade rumor, you're gonna have half this city dancing in the streets.
Oh, come on, man. You don't think that's just a little too extreme right now?
Research shows that sports fans are 78% more likely to dance in celebration than any other type of fan, and that includes fans of ballroom dancing, funny enough.
Thanks, Ash.
Look, I'm not saying you can't do the whole good soldier routine, but, dog, to play so well that a trade is impossible without doing any maneuvering in the press, I mean, that's extremely difficult.
Impossible.
Look, why don't you just play as well as you can while trying to work the press in your favor? I mean, it's the best of both worlds.
But isn't doing all that behind-the-scenes stuff bad for my brand?
Exactly.
Like, Ashley, what do you think?
Okay, it's a possibility that it could hurt your image, but that is a very remote possibility, okay? No one will blame you for wanting to stay on your own team. It's when you try to force your way out that there's a problem.
You know what? What if he's not comfortable trying to get another man